tonight to sing our national anthem, I present to you Katiana Rosario.
Present.
Members of the Keeping School Committee, Mr. Rosenthal, Mr. Hartberg, Ms. Dunn, Mr. Olympio. Teachers, parents, relatives, and students, welcome to PBD Veterans Memorial High School Auditorium. Tonight is a special night. We get to highlight our students and school to the community. I'm impressed with the high standards that are set in our classroom by your teachers, and how you meet those challenges daily. Just so that you know, and I'm sure parents are aware of this, our school day starts very early. Majority of us are here on time, and there's seven periods a day that these students have classes. It's very demanding. Some of the electives that they need to take have high standards, even though it may be in a class that a little bit more fun or a little bit more relaxed, there's still work to be done there. They finish the day about 2 o'clock, 10 minutes of two, and it's off to practice. When we were setting up the auditorium a little while ago, where Mr. Kroll was, they were still in here practicing for the musical. And out they went, some of them changed. Some of them had practice and changed in the locker rooms and are sitting amongst us. Their track meet, boys and girls, are out right now, softball team is out, the baseball team, so you may see some of those people trickle in. As soon as we move from this program, hopefully at a timely pace, they still need to go home and probably do 2.5 hours of homework tonight, and that's only Monday night. So I commend our students and families for supporting your son or daughter at home. There's a lot of work. You deserve this honor to be here tonight. If you're an underclassman, like students to come up on this side of the stage and receive your certificate and then sit on the podium. Okay? I would now like to introduce our superintendent of schools, Dr. Levine, to come to the podium for some brief comments and for the members. National anthem. Please stand up again.
people feel bad for you. So I happen to be a member of both of the associations that, a lifetime member actually, that is giving an award tonight to some of our students. The first award is for the Massachusetts Association of School Superintendents. Now this is every superintendent in the state of Massachusetts. I'm actually the executive director of the New England Association of School Superintendents, which is every superintendent in New England. This is a great organization, and when it recognizes kids, it does so with a great deal of care and a great deal of paying attention. So, the two students that are being recognized tonight by the Mass Association of School Superintendents for their academic excellence. First, please, Mackenzie Curry.
I'm at that age that I need glasses. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Major Ralph Rucco. I'm the senior aerospace science instructor for the ROTC program here at PV Veterans Memorial High School. Tonight I have the distinct pleasure to recognize cadets from the Corps Cadets who have sacrificed many hours of their free time after school, weekends, holidays, representing their school as members of the AFROTC Color Guard. You may have seen them perform over the last year at home football games or at City Hall. These cadets have performed well over 15 events so far this year and still have about 15 more to go. It is the responsibility of these cadets to not only perform in events, but train members, new cadets, in their precision and discipline of being a Color Guard member. This year, the Color Guard participated in Northeast Drill League competition at Gloucester High School, competing against other Air Force and Marine Corps Junior ROTC programs. Receiving the awards tonight are cadets Samantha Rondo, Nicole Duquette, Connor Fielding, Sal Aya, Leah Mae Hubis, Chaz Ricard, and Tristan Hubis.
Schools to participate in the annual Massachusetts School Banking Competition held at the Federal Reserve Bank in Boston on Friday, April 7th. Of our 20 students, 15 advanced to final rounds and were awarded top state honors in three categories. For fifth place in banking trivia, and call five students' names, Jackie Cordero, DeAndre Da Silva, Deanna Ruggiero, Holly Sherman, and Nicole Thomas.
Yeah.
Thank you. second place award winners for marketing, Connor Corrigan, Will DeMeo, Chris Gillen, Christina Green, and Tyler Norman. Okay, next is DECA. And many of these students who are receiving awards tonight are also boarding a flight tomorrow morning to go compete in Anaheim, California at international competition. And they have a 4:30 a.m. flight, so we wish them the best of luck in their next competition. The first award is for the Massachusetts DECA Student of the Month. This was for the month of September. This student was selected from a group of over 5,000 DECA students across Massachusetts. She was selected because of her volunteer work with Citizens for Adequate Housing, for work over the past summer planning for this current DECA initiative for this current year, and her 3 years of dedication to the PP DECA program. The award winner is Shelby McKee. Award winners. These students were selected because of their leadership potential. Beginning with Alex Locke, Sophia Vesconcillos, Rachel Gray, Holly Sherman, Ethan LeBlanc, and Sophia Medina. Second in the state for restaurant management is Isabella Valencia. O'Connor. Elizabeth Percio. Second place for her international business plan is Madison Conrad. And last, for first in the state, we have two award winners in the entrepreneur project, Kayla Connolly and Margaret Ampliotis.
Calls his editor a very funny young man and credits him with moving our online newspaper to the next steps of increased page count, visibility, and reach to a range of students, that he has been able to find a balance between real news and entertainment news. We debated over fake news. Therefore, tonight we honor Nicholas McLaughlin for his such powerful performances that it brought tears to the eyes of many in their competition, and of course amongst us who were there to hear their poems as well too. So I would like to honor today Hannah Belanger, Shima Okananwa, and Lexa Sempe. We also have an incredible number outstanding English students, and so we have a category for them that we call our English scholars. These are students who have outstanding insights in class. They have great grades and test scores. They love writing and they have a passion for the subject in the 4 years that they have been going to BBNHS. Plus, they've taken several courses, our electives, in the English department as well, too. And these wonderful ladies and gentlemen are Sean Cox, Rachel Ellis, Gerhard Kolo, Paul Gary McLaughlin again, Jolie Todd, Maya Shapiro, Isabella Valencia, Mackenzie Harry, Ashley Warrior, and Anne Santa Cruz. George Peabody said, some great good to his fellow men. In his honor, we nominate students in the department who represent those characteristics of humanity, scholarship, and wit. And this year, the winners of that particular book award, we have two this year, are Joseph Malherin and Samuel Newman. Of that kind of giant, if you will, amongst students and amongst humans.
This year's recipient is a student who has been described in those same terms. Courageous, fearless, witty, funny. You mention a book title and she goes and gets it in the library and she reads right away, whatever that may be. And that particular student is Carolina Wu.
Thank you.
Performing Arts, Mr. Jones.
Thank you. applause. Outstanding freshman this year is Robert Betancourt. Outstanding sophomore, Andrew Lang.
Social Studies Department tonight, Dean Mr. Gore.
So just a few awards to give out for the Social Studies Department. Mr. McHugh could not be here this evening. The first one is for Massachusetts Student Government Day delegates. Every spring, the Massachusetts legislature invites two students from high schools across the Commonwealth to spend one day assuming the role of state senators and representatives working on all the capacities of state government. This year's delegates are Bobby Sacramone and Maya Shapiro. Which I guess they are still out and working hard for the state. The next award is the Most Tuned In Award. This Most Tuned In Award is given to a senior who is most interested in discussing and spreading the news about current events. He has confidently shared his ideas, insights, and opinion with his peers in a manner that is intelligent and well thought out. The recipient of the Most Tuned In Award is Gary Cola. I believe Gary is with both Bobby and Maya, all doing well for the state. Mock trial competition. One of the most popular courses in the Social Studies Department is mock trial. Throughout the year, students learn the ins and outs of the courtroom, the roles of witnesses, judges, and the jury, and how to prosecute and defend a case. The students are excelled in the annual mock trial historical competition of the O.J. Simpson trial that was held at City Hall in early April. Voted on by the peers, the winner of the mock trial competition outstanding performers are, for the most outstanding witnesses, John McCone, Matt French, and Anthony Fleming. Most outstanding attorneys was Maya Shapiro, Patrick Pang, and Madeline Bunn. Studies Department offers several advanced placement courses. Tonight, we'd like to recognize the most outstanding student in each of these courses. For advanced placement in United States History, Rachel Coleman. For advanced placement in World History, Patrick Conway. Marcelo Rocha.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is William Kroll, and I'm the Dean of Students in the private in the PFC John Means Savage House here at PBMHS. At this point in the program, we will recognize our outstanding juniors who will be receiving awards from colleges based on their academic performance, leadership skills, and community involvement. These awards qualify the recipients for scholarships at these prestigious institutions of higher learning. We are very proud to introduce these students to you this evening. Dartmouth Club of Greater Boston is honored to provide a book award to a student in the junior class at PBMHS. The award is given to a student in the top 10% of the class who has attained an outstanding combined academic average. The recipient is a student who makes positive contributions to school and community activities. This year's recipient of the Dartmouth Book Award is Nuno Bazarian. Providing a book award to a student in a junior class at PBMHS. The award is presented to a student who combines excellence in scholarship with achievement in other fields. This year's recipient of the Harvard Book Award is Ryan Cormier. Michael's College Book Award for Scholarship and Service recognizes outstanding students who demonstrate a commitment to volunteerism and leadership in their community service endeavors. Recipients must also demonstrate academic achievement as evidenced by induction into the National Honor Society. This year's recipient of the St. Michael's Book Award is Andy May Sims. Smith College honors a student in the junior class at PBMHS with the Smith Book Award. The award is presented to a female student in the top 10% of the class who demonstrates outstanding academic achievement and leadership. This year's recipient of the Smith Book Award is Sarah Albudani. North Shore Wellesley College Alumni Club recognizes a student from the junior class each year with the Wellesley College Book Award. The award is presented to a female student who demonstrates outstanding academic achievement as well as contributions to their school and community. This year's recipient of the Wellesley College Book Award is Deanna Ruggiero. Secondary school juniors who have distinguished themselves in mathematics. The medal, first presented in 1916 to encourage students to pursue careers in math and science, qualifies the student for a $15,000 guaranteed annual merit scholarship at RPI. This year's recipient of the Rensselaer Medal is Sarah Buckley. conjunction with the PBMHS Science Department, the University of Rochester recognizes top science student in the junior class with the Bausch & Lomb Honorary Science Award and Scholarship Program. The student qualifies for a $30,000 scholarship over 4 years with acceptance to the University of Rochester. This year's recipient of the University of Rochester Bausch & Lomb Science Award is, don't sit down, Sarah Buckley. Social Studies Department at PBMHS recognizes a junior who has excelled in a rigorous social studies course and demonstrates a commitment to understanding and addressing difficult social and historical issues. The award qualifies the student for a $10,000 scholarship per year with acceptance to the university. This year's recipient of the University of Rochester Frederick Douglass Susan B. Anthony Award is Tabitha Bono. So next part of our program tonight is outstanding achievement in each academic discipline. We're going to present for the Business and Technology Department is Ms. Miller.
The Outstanding Achievement Award winner for the Business Technology Department is Alyssa Rice.
The outstanding award for English is, of course, given to
philosophy, college writing, and mystery detective fiction, which are the highest average for the most courses in English. To quote her teacher, she is a dedicated, inquisitive, community activist, a prolific reader whose wry sense of humor delights all. They say she is a true scholar who walks the walk, not the talk, walks the walk, and means to use her knowledge to benefit the community because it's the right thing to do. This lover of ideas, writing, and literature with a civic ethical compass is Caroline O'Neill.
Branchino will present the award for the Foreign Language Department.
Well, my name is Maria Branchino. I'm the head of the Foreign Language Department. This is my favorite time of the year because we get to honor the students who really excelled in a foreign language. If you are student at Liberty High School, when you enter, you are lucky enough to have a choice of 7 foreign languages, something that doesn't happen in a lot of high schools in Massachusetts. So without further ado, I'm going to announce the students who in 4 years have achieved outstanding work, outstanding speaking, outstanding everything, our cream of the crop here. We will begin with the top student of modern Greek, Ari Kamousis. The top student for Portuguese, Natasha de Silva. Italian, Yarisa Lopez. of student for French, Rachel Cross. And finally, top student for German, Mr. Samuel Newman.
Thank you.
And so I decided to make one serious statement and one more, humorous, I suppose. One, I could tell when the student was a freshman that they were going to be a tremendous leader. And she very quickly turned into the trumpet section mother, because they needed it. And now she's really the band mom. She takes care of all of us, including me. She is such a tremendous band student, such a tremendous musician, such a tremendous leader, Shannon Silver.
The Social Studies Department would like to recognize a senior who earned over 1/4 of his credits in the field of social studies. He exhibited hard work, contributed to class, and has a true passion for history, politics, and social science. The outstanding achievement in social studies goes to Marcello Rocha.
Thank you.
give out, one for each program. These students are students that have truly excelled in their technical competencies and have also shown a great passion for their career area. For Culinary Arts, Megan Danush.
Several categories of AP Scholar Awards. The following students have achieved AP Scholar recognition. First category, AP Scholar. This is granted to students who receive scores of 3 or higher, or 3 or more, on 3 or more AP exams. They are Benjamin Blake, Skylar Connigan, Talia Costa, William DeMayo, Rachel Ellis, Joseph Farhad, Sarah Feinstein, Raphael Gabriel, Chloe Jeezy, Colleen Dines, Andrew Hamill, Timothy Hope, Timothy January, Dan Manning, Brandon Hughes, Charles Oliveira, Patrick Pang, Alyssa Rice, Ravens Sinatis, Shannon Silva, Zenia Teslin, and Thomas Salusi. scores of 3 or higher on 4 or more of these exams. The recipients are Matthew Ball, Alexander Barr, Courtney Barrett, Emily Delavan, Sean Cox, Joseph Malheran, Samuel Newman, Ashley Royer, Taylor Ten, Isabella Valencia, and Stephanie Wango. Students represent the top 5% of the over 1.5 million students from across the nation who entered the 2016 competition by taking the 2014 PSAT National Merit Scholarship Qualifying Test. Please join me in congratulating our 2017 amended student, Katarina Bencourt. Rachel Gross, number 14, Stephen May, Number 13, Rachel Ellis. Number 12, Nicholas McLaughlin. Number 11, Justin Canuel. Number 10, Ashley Roya. And number 9, Marcella Rocha. Next eight will receive the George Peabody Medal at a ceremony at Peabody's Main Branch Library at the end of May. Number 8, Courtney Barrett. Number 7, James Russo. Number 6, Isabella Valencia. Number 5, Samuel Newman. Number 4, Kathy Skaggy. Number 3, Spencer May. The salutatorian, Ann Santa Cruz. The valedictorian of class of 2017 is Mackenzie Herrick. Congratulations again to all students, parents, and family members here tonight. Again, it's amazing how hard our students work. This is a select group, but all our students work hard. And we're very proud of our students here at the high school, and not only the things they do here, but outside of the school. But some of the students that weren't here tonight to receive the awards is probably because they were working at a sporting event or maybe even studying. So again, thank you to all. Enjoy the refreshments. It was a great night.